please stand for the first hymn.
Behold the oil of the sick, blessed by our bishop, for the anointing of all who suffer illness.
We pray that the Spirit of God may strengthen all who suffer illness, anxiety, or pain. May they experience the healing power of Christ through prayer and anointing with this oil. We pray also for those who serve in the healing professions and who care for the vulnerable.
Behold the oil of the catechumens, blessed by our bishop, for the anointing of our catechumens in preparation for their baptism.
We pray for those adults and children who will be anointed with this oil before their baptism. May they accept the challenge of Christian witness and experience the joy of new birth as a child of God in the family of the Church.
Behold the sacred chrism, oil mixed with sweet perfume and consecrated by our bishop for the anointing of the baptized who are to be sealed with the Holy Spirit.
We pray for those who will be sealed with this oil in the sacrament of confirmation, and for those infants who, having been baptized, will be anointed with chrism to share in Christ's ministry of prophet, priest, and king. May the baptized and confirmed be transformed into the likeness of Christ and witness to him as they share his work of service.
Thank you.
name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Special welcome to my fellow clergy and Father Rick, and to you all, and those of you who are watching online. We gather, every time we gather to remember Christ's call to do this in memory of me, and then to go out and serve God and serve the world. Lord Jesus, you call us to do this in memory of you. Lord, have mercy. You share with us your priestly mission. Christ, have mercy. You give us the supreme law of love. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest.
Called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month is to be the first of all the others for you, the first month of your year. Speak to the whole community of Israel and say, on the 10th day of this month, each man must take an animal from the flock, one for each family, one animal for each household. If the household is too small to eat the animal, a man must join with his neighbor, the nearest to his house, as the number of persons requires. You must take into account what each can eat in deciding the number for the animal. It must be an animal without blemish, a male 1 year old. You may take it from either sheep or goats. You must keep it till the 14th day of the month, when the whole assembly of the community of Israel shall slaughter it between the two evenings. Some of the blood must then be taken and put on the two doorposts and the lintel of the houses where it is eaten. That night, the flesh is to be eaten, roasted over the fire. It must be eaten with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. You shall eat it like this, with a girdle round your waist, sandals on your feet, a staff in your hand. You shall eat it hastily. It is a Passover in honor of the Lord. That night, I will go through the land of Egypt and strike down all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, man and beast alike, and I shall deal out punishment to all the gods of Egypt. I am the Lord. The blood shall serve to mark the houses that you live in. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and you shall escape the destroying plague when I strike the land of Egypt. This day is to be a day of remembrance for you, and you must celebrate it as a feast in the Lord's honor. For all generations, you are to declare it a day of festival forever. The word of the Lord.
The blessing cup that we bless is a communion with the blood of Christ.
The blessing cup that we bless is a communion with the blood of Christ.
How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me? The cup of salvation I will raise, I will call on the Lord's name.
The blessing cup that we bless is a communion with the blood of Christ.
Oh, precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful.
Your servant, Lord, your servant am I.
You have loosened my bonds.
The blessing cup that we bless is a communion with the blood of Christ.
A thanksgiving sacrifice I make, I will call on the Lord's name.
My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all his people. The blessing cup that we bless is a communion with the blood of Christ.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. This is what I received from the Lord, and in turn passed on to you. that on the same night that he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took some bread and thanked God for it and broke it. And he said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this as a memorial of me." In the same way, he took the cup after supper and said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Whenever you drink it, do this as a memorial of me." Until the Lord comes, therefore, every time you eat this bread and drink this cup, you are proclaiming his death. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. It was before the festival of the Passover, and Jesus knew that the hour had come for him to pass from this world to the Father. He had always loved those who were his in the world, but now he showed how perfect his love was. They were at supper, and the devil had already put it into the mind of Judas Iscariot, son of Simon, to betray him. Jesus knew that the Father had put everything into his hands, and that he had come from God and was returning to God. And he got up from table, removed his outer garment, and taking a towel, wrapped it round his waist. He then poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel he was wearing. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "At the moment, you do not know what I am doing, but later you will understand." "Never," said Peter, "you shall never wash my feet." Jesus replied, "If I do not wash you, you can have nothing in common with me." "Then, Lord," said Simon Peter, "not only my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus said, "No one who has taken a bath needs washing. He's clean all over. You too are clean, though not all of you are." He knew who was going to betray him. That was why he said, "Though not all of you are." When he had washed their feet and put on his clothes again, he went back to the table. "Do you understand," he said, "what I have done to you? You call me Master and Lord, and rightly so I am. If I then, the Lord and Master, have washed your feet, you should wash each other's feet. I have given you an example so that you may copy what I have done to you. The Gospel of the Lord. The central theme of this Maundy Thursday is love. We celebrate God's infinite love for us, perfectly revealed in his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who on the night before he died for us, gave us three precious gifts: the Holy Eucharist, the priesthood, and an example to follow. Tonight we celebrate the institution of the Holy Eucharist. Our catechism tells us that in the most blessed sacrament, the body and blood, together with the soul and divinity of Jesus Christ, is truly, really, and substantially contained. We know that Jesus gave us this precious gift not because we are perfect, not because we are saints, not because we earned it or deserve it, but because we are loved. And so tonight, we pray in a special way that in our lives and throughout our diocese, the Holy Eucharist will be firmly believed, devoutly celebrated, and intensely lived. Tonight we also celebrate the institution of the priesthood through which the Eucharist is perpetuated. It is the priest who makes present Christ himself in the Eucharist through the daily offering of Holy Mass. It is the priest who leads men and women to God. The world needs priests because ultimately the world needs Christ. Jesus has not forsaken his flock, but he keeps it under his constant protection through his priests. And so tonight, we also pray for our priests, that in addition to being holy and faithful, they will be known for the way they imitate the love of Jesus Christ, a love that is sacrificial, a love that does not count the cost, a love that is without end. And tonight, in just a few moments, we will commemorate the example of our Lord Jesus Christ, the one who teaches us how to love. The Gospel of John, just proclaimed this evening, is unique in the sense that it does not contain the familiar words of the institution of the Eucharist: "This is my body, this is my blood," but rather highlights for us the fact that even though Jesus knew he was Lord of all, he took off his clothes and bowed in service and gave us an example to follow. Out of love, we are called to wash the feet of one another. We do so when, instead of seeking to ascend, we seek to descend in service to our family, to our friends, to the poor and the lonely, the discouraged, the elderly, the sick, those crying out just to be noticed, crying out for our compassion. And we wash the feet of one another when we are willing to forgive even those who have hurt or offended us. On this sacred night, we celebrate God's infinite love for us revealed in Jesus Christ, whose body and blood we receive not symbolically, but truly and really. The one who washed the feet of his disciples and said, "What I have just done for you is to give you a model to follow. And as I have done for you, so you should also do." So may our love for God and for one another be reflected daily in our faithfulness to that gospel mandate carried out always in the holy name of Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen.
May we stand and pray. Let us adore our Saviour, who at the Last Supper, on the night he was betrayed, entrusted to the Church the memorial of his death and resurrection, to be celebrated throughout the ages. In faith, let us bring our prayers to the Lord.
We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for Bishop Richard and all the clergy, that they may be given the support and grace they need to carry out their ministry. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for those who lead communities and nations, that God may grant them wisdom and compassion. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for our families and friends and ask for the Lord's blessing on our parish and local community. We pray that we may develop a deeper belief in Jesus, the bread of life, and grow in our understanding of the Eucharist. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for those who are sick, especially those from our parish community. May God grant them healing and peace. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for those who have died, remembering especially those we have known and loved. Lord, in your mercy. We spend a few moments in silent prayer as we bring our personal needs before the Lord. Lord, in your mercy. With Mary, Mother of the Lord, we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Father, may the love of Christ gather us together as one. In your mercy, accept the prayers we make for ourselves and for the world, which we offer through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift your hearts to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son and Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, all they offered for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying the homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you on, as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is today, He took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who are those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
The Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall. Left hand side. Left. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Saturday. I'll ask you to just ask. You do.
Here we go.
You do. Here we go.